Question number 71. This is simply asking about the definition of environment is uncertain. Okay, simply what is uncertain environment? Uncertain environment is simple when an agent cannot fully observe the environment, plus it cannot determine where it should go to the next step. Okay, when the next state is undetermined, that means non-deterministic. So when the system, when the environment is not fully observable and not deterministic, then we can say environment is uncertain. Question number 72 is also a definition. In this it is saying, in artificial intelligence, a simple reflex agent select action on the basis of what? So a simple reflex agent select the actions on the basis of current state and just the only the current step, okay, current percept completely ignoring the rest of the percept history. This is simply, this says only current percept, okay, it will select the action on the basis of only current percept, not, it will not take history or next step in the observation. Then we have question number 77. This is simply a logic question, first order logic. This is saying, consider the following English sentence: Agra and Gwalior are both in India. So you can say Agra and Gwalior are both in India. You have to convert this into the first order logic formula. A student has written a logic sentence for the above English sentence in first order logic using the predicate in XY. In XY means X is in Y. Okay, this means X is in Y. If you say in Agra, India, this means that Agra is in India. Okay, this is the OR sign. This is saying Agra is in India or Gwalior is in India. We definitely know that this is not expressing the meaning of this. This is saying Agra and Gwalior are both in India. This is saying Agra or Gwalior are in India. So it is not expressing the meaning of this English sentence. So first thing we know that we have to find out whether it is syntactically valid or not. This is definitely syntactically valid. There is no problem with this because we do not need to use any quantifier with this. Okay. In first order logic, we use the quantifiers like universal quantifier and existential quantifier, but we do not need to use them here. So it is also syntactically valid, but it is not expressing the meaning of this English sentence, which means A is the right option. It is syntactically valid, but does not express the meaning of the English sentence. Like this, you can see the examples. These are the English sentences, and you have to find out the first order logic representation of these sentences. This is saying Lucy is a professor, all professors are people. John is the dean, dean are the professors. Like this, you have to find out the English first order logic translation of these English sentences. So Lucy is professor, simply you can write that is prof Lucy. This means that Lucy is a professor. Okay, like this, this is valid, then this is also valid. Agra is in India. There's no problem with this because it is saying all professors, all. So you have to use the quantifier. Quantifiers are not mandatory in the first order logic. They are optional, which means for all X, X is a professor and X is a person. So John is a dean. Then you can write simply John is the dean. You can write is dean John. So these are the valid formulas. There's no problem with the syntax of these. So that's why these two are the syntactically correct. There's no problem. Then we have this question. A knowledge base contains just one sentence, that is, there exists X as high as X Everest. Consider the following two sentences obtained after applying existential instantiation. What is existential instantiation? So this is simply existential instantiation. What we do is we take some real value with the in place of variable. So let's say we have this existential quantifier, there exists. This means that there exists at least one X for which this predicate Px is true. We can simply write this like this, Pe, where E is some new constant. Okay, where E is the new special constant which has not appeared earlier in the proof. For example, let's say you say there exists at least one person who will qualify the UGC NET. Okay, so let us say you are saying there exists at least one person P who will qualify the UGC NET. Okay. Let us say I'm saying P qualify. This means that there exists at least one person P who will qualify the UGC NET. This complete means P will qualify the NET. Okay. So this is in existential instantiation. What we do is we remove this reference, this is this quantifier, and we put some real value in place of this variable. So if I say, let us say, if I write like this, let us say I will substitute P with Priyanka. So now I can write like this, net Priyanka qualify. Okay, but the constant which you are putting should not appear in the formula already. So this means that Priyanka will qualify the net. Okay, so you are putting some real value here. You are saying there exists at least one person P who will qualify the net. I am saying that person is Priyanka. Okay, so you can write Priyanka will qualify the net. So you can see the example like this. There is someone who got a B in the course. There is at least one person, someone means there exists one person who got B in the course. So you can write it like this. There exists X got BX. B got the, X is a person who got the B. So after existential instantiation, you can see simply got B, or you can put anything. You can put E in place of this variable. Let's say is some girl. So she's the one who got the B. You can simply say you are simply putting the constant value in place of variable, and you are removing the this existential quantifier. So after applying this, we can say is this valid as high as averaged. We are saying that someone is as high as averaged. So we cannot put averaged in place of this variable X, because averaged is already appearing in the formula. So this is invalid. This is saying as high as is Kilimanjaro averaged. This is true. This is okay. After existential instantiation, what I am doing is in place of this X, I am putting some constant. Okay, this is okay. Like I said, qualify Priyanka and net. Okay, like this. So sentence A is unsound, but sentence B is sound.